In our last episode, we talked about how to use the zoom tool and the grabber tool to kind of move around the screen. And this is kind of where we left off, pretty close. And what I want to do now is I want to create some waypoints. I want to create a waypoint to kind of symbolize our starting point for the routes that we're going to be creating. And so let's just assume for a second that I'm going to be leaving from my home destination here in Carrollton, Texas on Young Drive. Now, you could do the same thing for your home location in your town. Now, you'll notice if I have the little pointer tool collect up here on the map tools, if I just point to Young Drive, it's going to kind of show me the address of where I'm pointing to. If I move it down here, it's going to show me a different address. But that's not as really as accurate as I'd like to be. I can actually just type an address in up here in the search field. And it will search for that address within the given map that we're searching. And it says here it searches up to 500 miles. So if we click on addresses here, you can see 4464 Young Drive shows up. So now if I click on that, it places a little marker down here, you can see, and it opens this little dialog showing us the address, the zip code, and everything else. Now, there's a few things I can do here. I have some other tools I can use. I can create a route using this as one of the waypoints, or I can, for now, just create a waypoint, and that's what I want to do. I want to click this little flag, and you'll notice when I do that, it places this little blue flag on the screen, and that's just kind of the default flag for a waypoint. You'll also notice that over here under unlisted data, it shows up 4464 Young Drive. Now, the reason it shows up under unlisted data is because we haven't created any lists yet and added this to one of those lists. We'll talk about lists in the next episode. But for now, I can select this waypoint over here in my unlisted data, and if I double click on it, I can actually change some of these properties. So I can type a new name, and I'm just going to call this home. It's easier for me to remember. I can also choose a different icon. We have a whole list of icons here. And I'm going to scroll up here and select the one that looks like a little house. And I can close this now, or I can go over here and add some advanced features. This shows me my longitude and latitude of the waypoint. I can also add contact information. So I could add a phone number here. So this is how we can modify some of the information related to this waypoint. I'm just going to close it for now, close this window. Now, to have a route created, you have to have more than one waypoint. Obviously, you have to have a destination. If this is our starting point, we have to have a destination. And I'm going to create a route eventually that takes me from my home in Carrollton, Texas to Memphis, Tennessee. So I can scroll around the map and try to find that location, or I can simply type in Memphis up here in the search window. And it will take me to the center point of Memphis, Tennessee. Probably the downtown area is where most of these cities it's going to take you. Now, you'll notice if I click on all points of interest, it'll show me several different businesses in Memphis within the map area that we're looking at right now. And just for the sake of demonstration, I'm going to select the Sheraton Memphis downtown as my destination. I could have just selected Memphis, but that's just going to take me to the center of town. I'd rather go to a hotel. So I'm going to create another waypoint as being the Sheraton Memphis downtown. If I click on that, now you see it has added it to our list of unlisted data over here. So now we have two different waypoints. Now we can create a route. Now I want to zoom my map out a little further so we can see Dallas and Memphis in the same screen. I think it'll be easier to kind of understand what's going on if we do that. And first I'm going to hit the space bar, and I'm just going to kind of slide all this over. Now I can see Dallas and Memphis on the same screen. I have Dallas over here, and I have Memphis up here on the upper right. Now, let's say we want to create a route from home to the Sheraton downtown Memphis. Well, I'm going to select home in our unlisted data, and I'm going to right mouse click on that, and I'm going to say create a route from waypoint. And that's going to create a new route from the home waypoint. So when we select that, you can see it opens this window over here. Now I'm going to drag it over here, which is a little more centered, so it's easier to look at. I could actually drag the Sheraton Memphis over here to the destination, or I could search for another destination. But since we created the Sheraton Memphis, I'm just going to click on that icon and drag it over here. So now we've instructed Basecamp to create a route from our home to the Sheraton Memphis downtown. So now if we say go, it will go out and calculate that route. Now I'm going to move this window out of the way so we can see our route. And you can see it's kind of a dark brown color right now. And if I look at this route, I can see because of the icons on the screen that it's basically put us onto Interstate 30. At some point over here, we get on Interstate 40 and somewhere up here. Well, I guess we take Interstate 30 all the way to Little Rock, and then we get on Interstate 40 into Memphis. So basically, this is taking the shortest, quickest route because of the way we have preferences set up in Basecamp right now. That's what it's instructed to do. So let's go take a look at preferences in the next video, and we'll see how we can create our route differently based on preferences. Now, I hope you're enjoying this video series. If you are, please give me a thumbs up on this video and click on that little subscribe button down below to subscribe to our channel. And if you click on the little bell icon, YouTube will notify you when we come out with new videos.